Hi everyone, this is a video for those of you that weren't here the day we did the lab. So you want to open your lab, copy and paste your link in. Let's go to our lab. Here's where you would change your object's mass. It says to get a mass between 300 and 600. It's going to give you different numbers every time. You'll have different numbers than everyone else in the class. So I'll use this 476 grams. Here's where you change your surfaces. So let's go to our lab. My mass is going to be 476 grams. So let's put that in here. 476. We have to convert that to kilograms. So we move our decimal three places to the left. So 0.476 kilograms is our mass. We can use that to get our weight. And since we know our normal force equals our weight, we will also have our normal force. So Fg equals 0.476 kilograms times G, 9.8, which equals 0.476 times 9.8, 4.66 newtons. Oops, sorry, I should type that in here. 4.66 newtons. I'm going to put that down here for our normal force. Well, my normal force, yours is going to be different because you'll have a different mass. 4.66 newtons. And then that's going to be the same the whole way down because you don't want to change your mass, which means you won't change your weight, which means you won't change your normal force. Okay, now we go to the next part where we have to change our surfaces and record static friction and kinetic friction. Remember, static is when it has not started moving yet, and kinetic is when it is moving. So we're going to hit start. And it's pulling on it right now, but it's not moving, and then it starts moving. So if you go down here, they've graphed the data for you. Your static friction is the maximum force right here of this diagonal line, because that's when it just started moving. So 0.56 newtons is our static friction. So let's put that here for this surface, 0.56 newtons. And then our kinetic is that solid line. So the top of the solid line, just below here, so maybe 0.37 newtons. Okay, once we have those, we can use them to find our coefficient of static and our coefficient of kinetic by using our formulas up here. So kinetic friction, we would do our kinetic friction, 0.37 newtons equals our coefficient of kinetic times our normal force, which is 4.66 newtons. And then you solve for your mu k by dividing 0.37 by 4.66. Remember, you'll have different numbers. 0.37 divided by 4.66, 0.079. And these are ratios, basically, so there are no units. And then for static, coefficient of static friction, you take your static friction value equals coefficient of static times 4.66 newtons, our normal force. Same thing, we divide 0.56 by 4.66. .120 or 0.12. Okay. This is a good sign because our static friction is always greater than our coefficient of static friction is always greater than our coefficient of, oh, this one was 0.079, wasn't it? 0.079. this is point. Okay, if you get something different, you probably swapped your values. Okay, and then you would just go to a new surface and repeat what you did here. Okay, and do not change your mask. You want to keep that the same. So then you just click on surfaces. I hit reset there. Okay.